promise to overthrow our love. Maybe too much ain't enough, and we won't make it out alive. She's got a rebel heart, she's had it from the start. Out there on the run again. She's got a rebel heart. One day she's gonna fall. She's got a rebel heart. She's up against it.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL.
Larry, we find ourselves right in the center of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex in Arlington at AT&T Stadium. Today, rivals square off in the NFC East, and we've got a great matchup between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Dallas Cowboys. They go play action here on first down. Being chased out left. Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Michael Kendricks. And he'll bring this one back to the 29. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's gonna go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave them with a third and 11. They don't want to waste this outstanding field position on this opening drive as they come up on third down. Play action to Sproles. Wins. Now he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. Justin Duran in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down. So now on fourth down, the Eagles will hand things over to their field goal kicker, and that's Caleb Sturgis. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this will remain a scoreless game. That opening drive looked good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
They go back to the air here after the INT. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And that'll bring up second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Throwing again. Prescott on second and 10. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. For Dez, when Romo was under center, he was more the focal point. Now you got Zeke and obviously Dak at quarterback playing a little bit of second fiddle to some degree.
Yeah, he still had, what, 8 catches, 82 yards in the game against Tampa. And I know the numbers are going to be about half of what he normally does. But here's the thing. When they get to the playoffs, he may very well be sitting first chair again because they'll need the big plays from Dez Bryant.
He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's go!
They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. It'll be a loss of 15 on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
It's hard to stay mad at a player who fights for yardage, even if it's not successful. But on this play, I'm just looking at what the defense did. We always talk about gang tackling and getting more people to the football. How about the job they did there, the discipline they had? No matter how hard he fought, more and more people showed up. and help create that big loss of yardage there, that's the kind of play that a defense gets excited about. Well, there were a couple of extra defensive backs in the game, so he really had nowhere to go with the football despite his search for an open receiver. Says to take off and run for it, but he comes up well short of the line to gain.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. To throw is Prescott, sliding out of the pocket. And he's got room. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Now a play fake here on first down. Able to get, he rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And now off to the races, down the right side. And a terrific return there. They're finally able to corral him down near the 11-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Old-school defensive tackle play dictated just stood up and dance with the guy in front of you. And if a guy came near, tackle it. New school, you don't want to just dance. You want to get past it, get upfield, and make the play in the backfield. A big-time play there.
It'll be a gain of five, and it's going to bring up a third and about seven left. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and seven.
For a guy who went to college as a quarterback, Ryan Matthews has turned into quite the power runner. If he could only stay healthy, well, his numbers would be huge, I think.
His numbers so far, two times over 1,000. And it's intercepted. The linebacker, Justin Durant, with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it. And the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy and can he step into a throw. And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets up. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. On first and 10, Prescott. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. A first-time Pro Bowler from 2015, Fletcher Cox. In there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. One man in the backfield, Elliott. Here's Prescott, dancing to his left. And he's got some space here. And he's going to go out of bounds, taking it down inside the 25. Give him 16 yards on the play. And they're going to have a third down. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Forced out to his left. He may try and run for this. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Fourth down, Prescott, nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. And hindsight 2020, I think they... Probably should have gone for the field goal, right?
The 3 points would look really good right now, but I think what we just saw there, analytics really starting to creep into the game because more and more teams are saying... The more you go for it, the better your odds of getting it, the better your odds of scoring 6 points instead of three. They took a chance there. It just didn't pay off.
Yeah, right here, the anti-analytics guys go thumbs up. It's a seven-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On second down, Ryan Matthews. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
Throwing now is Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. So completion on second down, that brings up third. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is that now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
So on fourth down, the Eagles will call on the left foot of Donnie Jones to punt it away. Officially a minute 54 to go in this first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. Prescott now on second down, buying time to his left. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. And the offense lining up first and 10.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Steps away to his left, and that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done. He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
Now Prescott, pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now the six-year man, Chris Jones, on to punt it away. Territory, and he got blown up on that play back at the 20. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the goat. Here they're going to be the goat.
Unfortunate too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just a call. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go ahead and fake it here. They feel like they've got something on. They've got the defense in the right spot. Just unsuccessful in that opportunity.
A gain of six there on first.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Wentz. He was looking for Doriel Green Beckham. And that takes us from second to third down. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. From the gun on third down, Wentz. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. Call it a gain of three, and it'll be fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we...
The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And on second and 10 now.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott on the move to his left. Now he's going to left. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now a play fake here on first down. It'll buy some time right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
Now that's the way you run offense. Understanding your clock situation. Excellent job getting to the sideline and getting out of bounds. That's the way to conserve time.
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. Stays on his feet. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
So with two ticks left here, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, it's a 30. Jeez, they don't even let their guys get a drink of water. All right, third quarter, let's get to it. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the Eagles hands team able to cover it up. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with... You and I both know the special teams coordinators.
Here we go now.
They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach. We can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about. Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Give him 5 yards on the run there, but it'll leave him with a definite third and long on the horizon. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Goes underneath for Sproles. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay. So another long try for three and another kick that comes up lacking.
Yeah, this isn't going to do any wonders for his field goal percentage, but you have to figure as a head coach that when you send a guy out there to try and kick from that distance, It's a 50-50 proposition at best.
Here's Prescott, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver.
Brandon, I think the NFL in recent years made an absolute brilliant tactical decision, and that was to move a lot of the divisional games to the end of the year in hopes that it would mean something. And, you know, remember at that time it was, hey, we don't want people to rest players down the stretch. Well, I think it's worked brilliantly because we've got some big-time games potentially showing up here at the end of 2016.
Adds intrigue and some big games. Intrigue also, though, because even if you've got two teams that maybe are having bad seasons, they're usually rivals, and that helps at the gate.
It certainly does. Helps in a lot of ways. Even if you're not playing for a playoff spot, as you said, if you're a rival, it still gets the interest of the fans.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. Fresh set of downs here.
Now, that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And this one complete to Witten over the middle. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
This could push to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. To throw is Prescott, being chased out left. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll make it second and goal.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Prescott dancing to it, and they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 5 yards on the pickup, and that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. Back now in Arlington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him. Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, This feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Pretty good running there. 9 yards. Sets up a third and one. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run.
And that was a nice, strong run by the guy they call the field general.
Now Ryan Matthews on third down. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
And they'll go on the ground. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It's a loss of two there, bringing out second down. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12.
And the defensive line controls the offensive front the way we just saw there. It doesn't allow any of the offensive linemen to leak downfield and get to the linebackers and block them on the second level. You end up with the type of play we just saw. Linebackers didn't have to fight anyone off, didn't have to knock anyone to the side, didn't have to elude anyone trying to block them. They just saw the play, ran to the ball, and finished things off.
From midfield, here's Wentz. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blow. It's the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
Prescott now out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. Now Prescott. Escobar with it over the middle. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll come out in the pistol. Prescott to throw it. And Escobar has it left side. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it. Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about.
And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Prescott to throw. And that one, his first incompletion in his last six passes. And it's third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Bryant, the lone receiver left. Now Prescott. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
And Bailey able to knock it through. And with a little over a minute to play, they have taken the lead. So we still wait on the first touchdown of the game, but his second field goal makes this now a 6-3 score.
And this would be the definition of winning ugly. Now you need to continue to ride your defense and hope that you can make this fourth quarter lead stand up.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And they're going to speed things up here. He'll look to throw. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Going to give this time to the tailback. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two. Back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this inside the 10 to the 7. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
And this one is right through. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds, and now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight all through regulation. No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Looking to throw, Prescott, he's got time. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And we have free football overtime. Here we go, my friend.
And the way this game...
It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the three-yard gain brings up a third down. Third down now following the run.
Tough day, tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about four. The linebacker, Anthony Hitchens, there on the stop. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
That catch good for five. It's third down.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Let's go! 3-3-9! 3-3-9!
He'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
All right, here we go.
A handoff left. It's Ryan Matthews. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Byron Jones in there to make the tackle.
But it was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. Now Wentz on third down. Goes underneath for Sproles. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And that changes everything here in OT. Well, when you've got a kicker out there who's already missed twice, he definitely would rather have about a 30-yarder rather than one from a neighboring county.
Can we agree to just give him a pass on that one? It would have definitely been a way to turn his mood around, but instead, it's a third miss and another scoreless possession.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Gavin Escobar, his big tight end, was the intended receiver. And it's second down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they missed a golden opportunity.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. Prescott now. He's got it. It's Escobar. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. First down, Prescott. Diluting the pressure right. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll make it a second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Let's go!
From the red zone now, Prescott. Incomplete.
think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
Here's Prescott, flush to his right, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Jordan Hicks in there to record another sack, their sixth of the afternoon.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and
then. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that will be their third and final in this overtime session. And as they talk it over, we take a break. We'll be right back. Bryant, the lone receiver left. And that is incomplete. The Cowboys' all-time receptions leader, Jason Witten, the intended target. And it's fourth down. So, and the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. And that is no good. And that changes everything here in OT. So it's his second missed field goal here that wouldn't have...